I had to restart it. Our camera fell. Okay? But like we were saying, they show you these movies to get your mind off of the salvation of the children of Israel. So when like you seen that video where Jake saw the chariots, he's like, oh, they're aliens, they're invading us. Why does he think that way, man? Because of the so-called white man. But there was a time where our people knew that they were the chariots of Israel. Can you hold all of that? And you can drop the other furniture. Yeah. Go on your phone and type in the chariots of Israel. In the blue letter, the chariots of Israel. Okay.
I don't know how to feel the ways of the heathen and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven. Chariots?
No, not
that
one.
Speaking about.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. Go ahead, speak, bro. They show you in these movies aliens and all wild green things. Oh yeah, like we were speaking about that Jake. He saw the chariots multiplying and he was like, aliens, we're being invaded. Why does he think that? Because the so-called white man told him that, man. Through his different movies, his bullshit ass documentaries, UFOs in Egypt, who built the pyramids. It was Israelites that built the pyramids, man. Why? Because we were cunning artificers. We were cunning crafters, okay? And we did it with perfect precision, man. And they can't understand how that we do such a thing in the so-called ancient world, man. Because the so-called white man and how you believe in that his modern technology is the apex of human intelligence, which is not, man. All this technology that Esau got, the so-called white man has, is old technology, man. Yahweh Bashem Awashai gave it to him real quick. This is Daniel chapter 12. Daniel's 12 and 10. Daniel 12 and 10. It says, many shall be purified and made white and slack. sorry, Daniel 12 and 4. But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased. Yeah, so we're at the time of the end, where the book, the Bible, the book is unsealed, and knowledge has increased, man. Okay? But again, this knowledge and technology that Esau has, it's old technology, man. At one time in the ancient world, it was preserved for certain men. Now everybody has it. Everybody has a cell phone, which is nothing but the Urim and the Thummim. Okay? You got the internet. You got the satellites in the outer space, which is nothing but the unicorn. Okay? Well, you got that big circle in the feed horn that's feeding this information out. So knowledge is increasing, man. Okay, you don't even need to go to school for half the things that you used to back in the day, man. 10, 20 years ago, you had to go to certain schools, like mechanic schools, to learn how to fix your own car, man. You had to entrust your car to a mechanic. Now you can go on YouTube and you can fix and build your own car, man. Change the oil, any car you got, whether it be a high-priced car or a low-priced car, a cheap car. You can fix it yourself. Do it yourself, man. DIY. You know, do it yourself, man. Go ahead.
This is the book of Second Kings, chapter 6, verse 17. And Elijah prayed and said, Yahweh, I pray thee, open his eyes that he may see.
Verse 11.
The book of 2 Kings, chapter 6, verse 11. Therefore, the heart of the king of Syria was sore troubled for this thing. And he called his servants and said unto them, will ye not show me which of us is for the king of Israel? And one of his servants said, none, my lord, O king, but Elisha, the prophet that is in Israel, telleth the king of Israel the words that thou spakest in thy bedchamber. And he said, go and spy where he is, that I may send and fetch him. And it was told him, saying, behold, he is in Dathan. Therefore sent he thither horses and chariots and a great host, and they came by night and compassed the city about. And when the servants of the man of God was raised early and gone forth, behold, a host compassed the city, both with horses and chariots.
Yeah, so Elisha saw this. Elisha saw this, man. He was troubled, man. Go ahead.
And his servant said unto him, Elias, my master, how shall we do? And he answered, fear not, for they that be with us are more than they that be with them.
Right, which is the chariots of Israel, man. See, at one point in time, these nations and our own people knew about the chariots, man. Just like our people knew about reincarnation. But over time, our people lost the understanding and knowledge of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. And the so-called white man, he took the truth and started lying about it, man. Okay? Go ahead.
And Elijah prayed and said, Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, I pray thee, open his eyes that he may see. And the Heavenly Father opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw, and behold, the mountain was full of horses,
yeah,
and chariots of fire round about Elijah.
Yeah, those chariots of fire are the chariots of Israel, man. What the so-called white man calls UFOs, man. Unidentified flying objects, but they're really identified flying objects, man. Okay? They're really identified flying objects. Alright? But we knew them as the chariots of Israel. So that's why we call them identified flying objects, man. They're the chariots of Israel. I'm not sure, man. They're the chariots of Israel. Go ahead.
18, and when they came down to him, Elisha prayed unto the heavenly Father and said, smite this people, I pray thee, with blindness, and he smote them with blindness according to the word of Elisha.
Oh, that was it on that. Can you go to your phone, the chariots of the Most High, or 200,000. You see, the so-called white man is an unbelieving piece of crap, man. Okay? He wants you to believe that alien ships, so-called alien ships, fell to the earth, and that you can beat them by way of a nuclear missile. Because that's the highest form of technology Esau got. That and the lasers, man. Meanwhile, the chariots of Israel are way more advanced than that, man. They can move 7,000 miles at an hour, man. They can stop at a drop of a dime. They can expand. They can decrease in size, man. They can shift. Morph. They can cloak themselves, man. Something that Esau can't do. He has cloaking abilities with certain things, but not with those kind of things, man. Okay? So Esau, he don't want you to believe. Like Esau, he doesn't want you to have hope and salvation, man. You find it, brother?
Wait. This is the book of Psalms, chapter 68, verse 17.
Yep.
The chariots of the heavenly Father Yahweh, while Yahweh Shai, are 20,000, even thousands of angels.
Yeah, there's 20,000, even thousands of angels. Go ahead.
The Lord is among them, as in Sinai, in the holy place.
Right, you can't tell no goddamn nigga. You can't tell no nigga that chariots is gonna save him, man. He can't believe that. That's too far-fetched for him, man. Why? Because the so-called white man gave him that belief that, hey, you know, if you ever see a chariot, it's an invasion. It's an invasion of aliens, man. And even Jake was calling for the cop. Hey, y'all shoot him, do something. Like they can lock the angels up. Okay? Like they can lock the angels up. And a black woman told them, like, they can't do nothing. And they couldn't. And they won't be able to do nothing, man. You can drop that, you know, you got something else?
I was looking for the tip of Elijah.
Oh, yeah. This is, 2 Kings 2:11. Elisha was Elijah's understudy. He was a prophet too, but Elijah was a prophet at the time, and Elisha was like basically a scribe, and he was a man, and then he became a prophet. And Elijah said, go ahead. Read verse 2.
This is the book of 2 Kings, chapter 2, verse 9. And it came to pass when they were gone over, verse 8. And Elijah took his mantle and wrapped it together and smote the waters, and they were divided hither.
Yeah, Elijah has spiritual powers, man. He uses mantle to smite the river, man, to open it up like Moses, like Yahweh Shai had Moses do.
And they were divided hither and hither and thither,
yep.
So that they too went over on dry ground.
Yep.
And it came to pass when they were gone over that Elijah said unto Elisha, ask what I shall do for thee before I be taken away from thee.
Yep. And so Elisha wanted a promise from Elijah. Go ahead.
And Elisha said, I pray thee.
Elisha
said, I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me.
God.
And he said, thou hast asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if thou see me when I am taken from thee, it shall be so unto thee.
Right. But, he got an opportunity to see this, Quinn.
But if not, it shall not be so.
Right.
And it came to pass as they still went on and talked, that behold, there appeared a chariot of fire.
A chariot of fire, which was a so-called spaceship, a so-called UFO, okay, with lights. Go ahead.
And horses of fire, and parted them both asunder.
Yeah, so we know that they wasn't physical horses, Nazariah, Nasty Nas. These were chariots, man. Go ahead.
And Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven.
What you would call a so-called tractor beam, okay? Which the so-called white man shows you that. Even in some movies, they show you circles flying down and then hovering around an individual and then taking them up, man. He was abducted, man, okay? He was taken up in a whirlwind. Go ahead.
And Elisha saw it and he cried, my father, the chariots of Israel.
The chariots of Israel, man.
And the horsemen thereof.
So that's what those so-called UFOs are. The chariots of Israel, man. The chariots of God, man. And that's why Yahweh Shai said, when he comes back, shall he find faith in the world, man. Because these people, Israel, two-thirds of Israel, you don't have no faith, man. You don't have no faith that those are going to be saved, because when them chariots come back, not only are they going to be saving the elect of Israel, they're going to be zapping two-thirds of Israel, man.
That's
and the
right.
rest of these heathen nations, man. You're going to be getting hit with beams, man. So-called laser beams, man. Turned into powder, man. Can you drop that and get 2nd Exodus chapter 13, verse 8? Okay? But you people, you don't believe that. That's far-fetched for you, man. But if the so-called white man was out here, standing here telling you these same things, you believe it. Like that one Jake, he believes in the Anunnaki, the fallen angels as a form of some type of big rock beings, like they show you in a book, movie Noah. Okay? You believe everything that comes out this lying-ass devil's mouth. When it's coming from your own people, you don't want to hear it, man. But it's too far-fetched, man. Meanwhile, you'll go to the movies and watch an Edomite superhero fly through a goddamn wall at 300 miles an hour, okay? Breaking the sound barrier. And you believe that shit, man. Or we're gonna have transhumanism. We're gonna be able to amalgamate bio with tech. We're just gonna be able to see faster. We're gonna have to see further. Move, walk faster. You see? Go ahead, keep reading.
2nd Exodus 13:8.
Yeah.
The book of 2nd Exodus, chapter 13, verse 8. And after this, I beheld, and lo, all they which were gathered together to subdue him.
Yep, because all these nations, they're going to try to come fight. And a beautiful illustration of that is in Independence Day, man. Where Satan's angels were fighting against Yahweh Bashim Yahweh's angels, man. Which in that movie, they had some big-ass slimy aliens, you know, with these big-ass heads. Or they breathe just like us. You up there, and that's what Esau does. If he could get an angel, he would try to dissect them, man. You know? But you can't touch an angel. But that's what you do, man. Okay?
All they which were gathered together to subdue him were sore afraid.
Yeah, when they see Yahweh Shai standing on top of this, let's get the meat out of it.
The book of 2nd Exodus, chapter 13, verse 1.
Yep.
And it came to pass after 7 days, I dreamed a dream by night, and lo, there arose a wind from the sea, that it moved all the waves thereof. And I beheld, and lo, that man waxed strong with the thousands of heaven. And when he turned his countenance to look.
Yeah, that's that man waxed strong with the thousands of heavens. That's Yahweh Shai, man. Okay, that is Yahweh Shai, man. Standing on top of a chariot with the holy host of angels, man. Coming to do battle, man. With the archangels, Michael, Raphael, Uriel, okay, Gabriel. All of them going to be here, man. Go ahead.
All the things trembled that were seen under him.
Yep, everything going to be trembled. All the people, all the earth. Okay, go ahead.
And whensoever the voice went out of his mouth, all they burned that heard his voice.
Yep.
Like as the earth faileth, yeah, when it feeleth the fire.
Yeah, and that's what's gonna happen, man. Because at the same time, you're gonna have nuclear missiles dropping, then you're gonna have chariots hitting with laser beams, burning you up, man. Okay? Go ahead.
And after this I beheld, and lo, there was gathered together a multitude of men out of number from the four winds of the heaven to subdue the men that came out of the sea.
Yeah, so from north, east, south, and west, because during that time of Yahweh Shah's return, you're going to have World War III breaking out. All these nations, they're going to be fighting each other. They're going to stop fighting each other, and they're going to try to band together and fight against Yahweh Shah, man. Can you read that again?
2 Kings 13:5. And after this I beheld, and lo, there was gathered together a multitude of men out of number.
Yeah, all these different nations, go ahead.
From the four winds of the heaven to subdue the man that came out of the sea.
Yep, which is Yahweh Shah. Go ahead.
But I beheld, and lo, he had graved himself a great mountain and flew upon it.
So Esdras couldn't see that big, where the ship was so big, okay? It was so big that he couldn't see where it came, where it started, and where it ended, man. And Yahweh Shah is going to be standing on top of one, man. And that's a Jake move, man. That's a Jake move, man. Esau, he'll creep out of the fucking ship, looking all nasty. But Yahweh Shah, he's standing on top of that motherfucker like, I run this, man. And it's my show.
Right.
Okay? Standing up there, he going to be, I just picture him, man, looking thorough as shit, you know what I mean? Y'all, Jake get into it, you know, Jake like this. Jake get some new shit on him like this. Taking pictures like this and shit like this. You know what I'm saying? Little jail pose and shit. You know what I'm saying? Yahweh Shah gonna be standing there like, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Looking angelic. Flexing. Hey, that's right, brother. Flexing on your ass, man. Keep reading, bro.
Verse 7. But I would have seen the region or place whereof the hell was graven.
Yeah, he would have seen it, but he couldn't.
And I could not.
And hey, and a good description of that is, hey, did you see that chariot video where they had Brazil, the ISS? So it was like a 3,000, 5,000 square mile chariot, man. Made of gold, man. Made of gold. Go ahead.
And after this, I beheld, and lo, all they which were gathered together to subdue him.
Yeah, all those different nations, they want to try to fight with their F-30s, their unmanned vehicles, man. UAVs.
Space Force.
Hey, the Space Force, hey, Donald Trump, he's coming up with a Space Force, man. Okay, all them lasers, okay? They're gonna try to fight the Lord, go ahead.
We're so afraid, yeah, but yet there is fight.
Yeah, they're gonna be afraid when they see Yahweh Shah, but he's gonna put the spirit on them and keep fighting, man. Go ahead.
And lo, as he saw the violence of the multitude that came, he neither lift up his hands nor held sword.
He didn't do nothing. He just stood there like, really, nigga? Go ahead.
Nor any instrument of war. But only I saw that he sent out of his mouth as it had been a blast of fire.
Yeah, which is, those are laser beams coming out from chariots, man. Go ahead.
And out of his lips a flaming breath, and out of his tongue he cast out sparks and tempest.
Yep, which is laser beams. Go ahead.
And they were all mixed together, the blast of fire, the flaming breath, and the great tempest, and fell with violence upon the multitude, which was prepared to fight, and burnt them up, every one.
Yep, that's what's gonna happen, man. Because like in the Esau's movies, they show you what's your name, man? See yourself in that poster? See yourself in the poster right here? He said it. He said it. Edom. Hey, can you read that portion again, brother?
No. 2 Esdras 13:11. And they...
Are you finished, Esau? So-called white man, you're done, man. You and your cave beast of a bitch. Go ahead.
And they were all mixed together, the blast of fire, the flaming breath, and the great tempest.
Yeah, you're not ready for that, man. Again, when you see the second coming of our Lord, man, hey, the scripture says men's hearts gonna be stopping, failing them for fear, man. Motherfuckers gonna have heart attacks, man. And then you're gonna see the war. You're gonna see how all these jets gonna try to get in front of them, all these UAVs, man. All these people, they're gonna be scared of shit, but they're gonna still fight, man. People gonna be shitting on themselves, pissing on themselves, man. Keep reading.
Which?
Salaki.
And they were all mixed together, the blast of the fire, the flaming breath, and the great tempest, and fell with violence upon the multitude, which was prepared to fight, and burned them up, every one, so that upon a sudden, of an innumerable multitude, nothing was to be perceived, but only dust and smell of smoke.
Hey, yeah, so all them armies, they're gonna go out like Thanos did, the rest of them Marvel superhero comics, man. All you're gonna see is ashes, man. We're showing you that Esau knows that about this story, man. Because Thanos was Jehoshaphat, man. Hey, he didn't kill everybody. He just only killed the majority of people on the earth. But he left some, an elect, man. And when everybody died, man, all you seen was ashes, man. Ashes, man. We gotta go see Ant-Man and Wasp today, bro. You know what I'm saying?
I got a quick read.
Go ahead, brother.
This is the book of Micah chapter 5, verse 15. And I will execute vengeance in anger and fury upon the heathen, such as they have not heard.
Yeah, and that's what's coming, man. Because these heathen nations, man, hey, man, it's been a long time since the Lord showed himself, man. Because you heathens, you're all proud. Like, if there's a God, then why does he show himself? Hey, he's not dealing with you, bitch.
Right.
He's only dealing with the Israelites, man. And we don't need to see him to believe in him, man. We know he is, man. Through faith, man. Okay? And when the Lord bring out this judgment, it's going to be... Can you read that again, brother? That was cold, man.
It's the book of Micah, chapter 5, verse 15. And I will execute vengeance in anger and fury upon the heathen.
Yeah, he's going to execute vengeance. Vengeance for what? For what you did to his people, man. And his land.
Such as they have not heard.
Such as they have not heard. So the violence that Yahushua is going to bring to you so-called white people, two-thirds of you Israelites, you black spending Native Americans, and the rest of you heathen nations, is going to be like something you've never heard, man. Go ahead. Okay, brother.
I'll finish. 2 Esdras 13 and 11.
Done.
When I saw this, I was afraid.
Yeah, when he saw it, he was afraid, man. Go ahead.
Afterward, saw I the same man come down from the mountain and call unto him and other peaceable multitude.
Yeah, and that's the elect, man. Hey, look at that license plate, man. 144, man. We're speaking about that. That's the elect, man. That's the elect. Can you hold that?
There it came,
bro. You see? Hey, that's the spirit. Rocket thy Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, man.
Rocket Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai.
That's right, man. Hey, can you hold that and go to, let's finish that portion up. And peaceful multitude yet again.
And afterwards I saw the same man come down from the mountain and call unto him another peaceable multitude.
Yeah, which is the elect.
And there came much people unto him,
yep.
Whereof some were glad, some were sorry, some of them were bound,
yep.
and others some brought of them that were offered.
That word, I don't know. Right here. Offered.
And other some brought of them that were offered. Then was I sick through great fear.
Yeah, because those visions, man, they gave the prophet sicknesses, man. When they woke up, you know, they had to be bedridden, man. Hey, so go to 2 Esdras chapter. Chapter 2, verse 40.
It's the book of 2 Esdras, chapter 2, verse 40.
Hey, so Esdras, man, he had a powerful vision, man. He had powerful vision, and he seen the same vision John saw, man, in Revelation, man. Okay, because see, the Lord's going to come back destroying two-thirds and destroying these heathen nations and their leaders, okay? But then he's going to call that peaceful multitude with the men. And this is going to happen to the men, and that peaceful multitude is the elect of Israel, man, okay? Whom we hoping to be, man. We hoping that we're some of those hopeful elect members, man. because this is the reward that the elect men are going to receive from Yahushua himself, the man himself. You know, that's going to be a moment where none of us ever going to forget, man. We're going to be talking about that to our children's children, 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 man.
That's right.
Showing them video, man, of the day we got our first crown from Yahushua, the son of Yahweh himself, man. Lord willing, we endure to the end, man. Okay? Because we're going to be afraid, but guess what? We're going to be happy at the same time, man. Because we know what it is, man. Meanwhile, the rest of the world, they're going to be running around in a disarray, man.
That's right.
Okay?
The book of 2 Esdras, chapter 2, verse 40. Take thy number, O Zion, and shut up those of thine that are clothed in white, which have fulfilled the law of the Heavenly Father.
And that white is righteousness, man. Okay?
The number of thy children whom thou longest for is fulfilled.
Yep.
Beseech the power of the Heavenly Father that thy people, which have been called from the beginning, may be hallowed. I, Esdras, saw upon the Mount Zion a great people,
yep,
whom I could not number.
Yeah, which is the mixed multitude.
And they all praised.
And 144,000 men. Okay, go ahead.
And they all praised.
And hold on, matter of fact, I'm sorry, brother. Read that portion and I'm going to go to the scripture. Read that scripture and I'm going to go.
I, Esdras, saw upon the Mount Zion a great people whom I could not number, and they all praised the Heavenly Father Yahweh by Hashem Yahushua with songs.
Yep. And what's that song? The truth, man. Okay? This is Revelation 7 and 1. And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree. And I saw another angel ascending from the east, having the seal of the living power. And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels, to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea, saying, hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the trees, till we have sealed the servants of our power in their foreheads, man. That's that the law spoken about in Ezekiel 9 and 4, man. Okay? And I heard the number of them which were sealed, and there were sealed 144,000 of all the tribes of the children of Israel, of the tribe of Judah, Yehudah, sealed 12,000, of the tribe of Reuben, Rehoboam, was sealed 12,000, of the tribe of Gad, was sealed 12,000, of the tribe of Asher, or Asher, was sealed 12,000, of the tribe of Naphtali, was sealed 12,000, of the tribe of Manasseh, was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Shemaiah, Simeon, was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Levi, or Lawiah, was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Issachar, or Yashashkar, was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Zebulun, was sealed 12,000. Of the tribe of Joseph, was sealed 12,000, which is the tribe of Ephraim, okay? And of the tribe of Benjamin, was sealed 12,000. And after this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude which no man could number, of all the nations and kindreds and people and tongues, stood before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed with white robes and palms in their hand, and cried with a loud voice, saying, salvation to our power, which sitteth upon the throne and unto the Lamb. And that's right, which that's a mixed multitude, man.
That's right.
We're reading about that in Ephesus account too, showing you that the Apocrypha and the rest of the Bible, they're all canon, man. Okay? Right? You got it, bro.
2 Esdras chapter 2, verse 43. And in the midst of them, there was a young man of high stature, taller than all the rest.
Yeah, so Yahushua, he's going to tower us, man. Go ahead.
And upon every one of their heads, he set crowns.
Yep.
And was more exalted, which I marveled at greatly.
And that's why we out here, man, because we want to receive that reward, man. We hope to receive that reward, man.
Right.
A crown from Yahushua himself, man. The son of the Lord, man. Okay?
So he asked the angel,
an incorruptible crown. Something you can't buy, something you can't corrupt. Okay? Go ahead.
So I asked the angel and said, sir, what are these? He answered, and he said unto me, This be they that have put off the mortal clothing to put on the immortal.
Yep, and which is that's we got that mortal clothing on right now, but when we get in them chariots, our bodies are going to change, man. Okay, as according to 2 Corinthians, hold that slot. 2 Corinthians. First Corinthians 15. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 50. Then I say, brother, flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of the Most High. Neither doth corruption inherit incorruption. So this is flesh and blood that we're in right now. This abode, this body. Okay, and it's a corruptible body as well. Okay? And these bodies can't inherit the kingdom. So we're not even taking these bodies with us, man. So you know how people get on us about how we look. You know what I'm saying? Look, man, it don't matter, man. Because this shit is gonna be done away with, man. Okay? You scoffers, you wanna talk about a brother's visage, man. Dumb, dirty whores, you wanna talk about a brother's visage, man. But we're not even taking these bodies into the chariots, man. Because flesh and blood can't go into the kingdom of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, not this flesh and blood. Okay?
Right.
Behold, I show you a mission. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised in corruption, and we shall be changed. So we're going to be changed, man. This dead is going to be raised incorruptible, man. Okay? For this corruptible must put on the incorruption, and this mortal must put on the immortal. So we're going to have immortal bodies, man. We're not going to be able to die, man. Nothing's gonna be able to kill us, man. Okay? No disease, no weapon, nothing, man. Okay? And that's what we're gonna inherit in the kingdom of heaven. Go ahead, we got it again, bro.
It's the book of 2 Ezra, chapter 2, verse 45. He answered and said unto me, this be they that have put off the mortal clothing.
Yeah, we put this clothing off. Go ahead.
And put on the immortal.
Yep, and the immortal, man, which is gonna be those with the new bodies, man. Which starts with the spirit first, man. Go ahead.
And have confessed the name of Yahweh.
Oh, that's an important key. And have confessed the name of Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai, man. That's what we're doing out here, man. Go ahead.
Now are they crowned and receive palms.
Now we're going to receive those crowns and those palms in our hand, man. Which those are a symbol of peace, man. Go
ahead. Then said I unto the angel, what young person is it that crowned them?
Yeah, Yahweh Shai is young, man. He's a young man. He's in his youth, looking good, man. Okay, when he died and was risen, he was 33 years old, man. He was young, man. He's in his prime. Okay? So he's gonna be in his angelic prime again, man. Go ahead.
And giveth them palms in their hands.
Yep.
So he answered and said unto me, it is the Son of the Heavenly Father Yahweh.
It's the Son of Yahweh. Who is the Son of Yahweh? Yahweh Shai. Whom the world calls Jesus. Go ahead.
Whom they have confessed in the world.
Yep. And we're doing that right now. We're confessing the Lord in the world. Go ahead.
Then I began greatly.
You see, it's funny to see these Edomites. They walk up here and they do this shit like people turn their faces up. Okay? But you don't know, we're gonna be rulers, man. We're gonna be gods on the earth, man.
That's right.
Gods. Can you hold that and get Psalms 86:2? 82:6. Psalm 82:6. We're gonna be gods on the earth, man. We're not gonna be mortal, man. Okay? And you nations, man, you're gonna come bowing down, man. Head first, man. Knees, head, knees, shoulders. Okay? You're gonna bow down to us, man. Go ahead.
82:6.
Yep.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 82, verse 6. I have said, ye are gods.
We are gods, man. Powers, man.
And all of you are children of the Most High Yahweh.
All the Israelites are sons of the Most High, man. All the Israelite men and the women, we're children of the Most High, man.
But ye shall die like men.
Yeah, and we die like men because we sin, man. Because of that sin.
And okay? Fall like one of the princes.
And fall like one of the princes, Esau, Edom. But guess what? When we get those new bodies, they're going to be perfect, man. Right. Starting off with our spirit, which is going to be perfect, man. Okay? So we're just going to be gods, man. We're not going to fall like one of the princes, man. Okay? We're going to have God-like power on the earth, man.
That's right.
And everywhere else, man. Can you read it? Not Psalms. Thank you, Second Esdras.
It's the book of Second Esdras. Oh. Chapter 2, verse 46. Then said I unto the angel, what young person is it that crowneth them and giveth them palms in their hands? So he answered and said unto me, it is the son of the heavenly father Yahweh.
Yep, Yahweh Shai, that's the son of Yahweh, it's Yahweh Shai, go ahead.
Whom they have confessed in the world.
When we confess in the world, man, and we're doing that right now.
Then began I greatly to commend them that stood so stiffly.
And that's what we're doing, man. And that reward is not going to be given to everybody, man. That's only for the elect starting off, man. And then the 2/3 of our people that die, they're going to come back as our children. And they're going to have incorruptible bodies. They're going to have righteous spirits, man. But they're going to have to know what we know by death by pain, man. Okay? Because who's the only one standing stiff for Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, man? The men of the Lord, man. Starting off with the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, man. And the brothers on down. We're standing stiff for the Lord, man. But everybody else just walking by, like, whatever. Casual occurrences. Oh, this ain't shit. Fuck out of here. They don't mean nothing. It's all about this paper, man. It's all about these holes, man. These clothes, man. Okay?
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 149, verse 5. Let the saints be joyful in glory.
That's right.
Let them sing out loud upon their beds.
That's right.
Let the high praises of Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai be in their mouth,
yep.
And a two-edged sword in their hand.
And we're going to get the two-edged sword, man.
To execute vengeance upon the heathen.
Vengeance upon the heathen.
And punishment.
So they're going to be slaves in the kingdom of heaven, man. It ain't going to be a utopia for the whole world. Hey, this is utopia for the whole world, man. And look at this shit, man. All this confusion. But in the kingdom of heaven, man, we're going to execute vengeance upon you heathens, man.
That's right.
We ain't going to do it now. We're going to do it when the Lord gives us the power. And we're going to have a two-edged sword in our head to execute vengeance upon the heathen. Go ahead.
And punishment upon the people.
And punishment upon the people, man.
To bind their kings with chains.
Being a Rothschilds. Old daddy, dirty Rothschilds, dirty deeds. Over here. You're going into hardcore slavery, man.
That's right.
You're going to be the first fruits of slavery in the kingdom of heaven, man. You. You.
That's right. And their nobles with fetters of iron.
And your nobles with fetters of iron, meaning you're going to be shackled from neck to feet, man. Neck, hands, feet, waist, and neck, hands, waist, feet. You're going to be shackled, man. Because see, you Edomites, man, you walking around here missing something, man. And that's them shackles, man. Ain't gonna never be another Edomite walking around without shackles on their head and necks, man. Even a little Edomite baby. As soon as that big head water baby, that big head, big water head baby is born, they're gonna have chains on his neck. You know how they put a little bracelet on your kid's arm, the ankle? Well, guess what, man? There's gonna be a nurse sitting there with age. Soon as that dirty thing comes out of that filthy-ass birth canal you call a vagina, you Edomites, women, hey, we're going to have a chain right there. Soon as it come out, it's going to choke, it's going to yoke his ass up. You're going to hear that little yoke. It's going to be that yoke, man. Okay? You're not going to be able to breathe. You're going to be suffocating. You're going to learn to breathe with the most minimal amount of oxygen, man. Okay? Starting off with your elite. Of all the nations, man. Not just the elite of Edom, but all you nations, because all you nations got an elite, man. And your ass is going, man. You going head first, go ahead.
Verse 9. To execute upon them the judgment written, this honor have all his saints. Praise ye the Lord Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai.
They kind of like the brother GMS Inquirely said, singing white cracker spirituals, man. With that, I don't even know how that's gonna happen. They not spiritual, man. Hey, but you better sing me a song. And you better not sing no shit, nothing like sweet low, sweet share. You better sing. You better sing to somebody to come save your ass, man. I want to hear singing, mirth. And we're gonna beat rhythm into your ass, man. Rhythm is gonna get you tonight. Say you're gonna be fucked up, man.
Right.
Back in 2 Ezra chapter 2, verse 48. Then the angel said unto me, go thy way and tell thy people what manner of things and how great wonders the heavenly Father Yahweh, thy power, thou hast seen.
Yeah, and that's what we're doing, man. We're telling you these great wonders, man. And matter of fact, can you get 2 Ezra 15 and 1? Because these words are true, man. You people wandering around here thinking that these words are not true. Okay, you think that these words are false, man. You think that these words are just a make-believe book. No, ain't nothing in this book make-believe, buddy. Everything in this book is real. Real. Everything signed and sealed. Okay.
This is the book of 2 Ezra, chapter 15, verse 1. Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people.
Yeah, and we're speaking in the ears of the people, whether they hear it or forbear it. Go ahead.
The words of prophecy.
Words of prophecy, meaning the speaker things are going to happen before they happen. Go ahead.
Which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord Yahweh.
And it's the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah that drives us, man. Hey, this is no will of our own. Hey, it's the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah that's inducing us to come out here and to speak these words, man. These are not our words, man. These are the words of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah.
That's right.
Called Kadosh, man. Read.
And cause them to be written in paper.
And they're written in paper, which is the Bible.
For they are faithful and true.
And they're faithful and true. That's the point right there, man. Hey, right. Hey, do you guys believe in the Bible? You guys believe in the Bible? I'm gonna ask you. You believe in the Bible? Hey, you're an Edomite. And you're going into slavery. We're gonna fuck you up. And that's a devil, man. And you ask a Jake, man, a friend, yeah, I believe in it. Some of them say, no, I don't. Or ask him, man, being a devil. Because a white man don't believe in the Bible, man. You don't believe these words, man. So he got his woman. You don't believe in the word, man. She's about to be cooking. He probably already cooking her ass out, man. You got Jake giving her the BBC and shit while he's filming shit, man. Goddamn devil. Oh, stop. Hey, we about to close up anyway.
So,
hey, you got anything else?
I was looking for that scripture that says, my words
shall not
return to
me void. Oh, yeah. Probably won't do the same thing in a second. So long as the food. Yeah, about an hour. Yep. This is This is Isaiah 55 and 11.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 55, verse 11. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please.
Yeah, so the word of the Lord don't go out void, man. The Lord don't just speak a word for nothing, man. Okay? Everything that the Lord said and has written down in his book It's going to happen, man.
That's
and
right.
And it's not going to return to him empty, man. Hey, do you believe in the Bible? You believe in God? Okay, hey, you know that America is spoken about the Bible and the devil on the grave and the portion of the Bible is going to be destroyed by nuclear fire in your lifetime, in our lifetime. Okay, and that salvation is built for Israel according to the Bible. Now, I don't know what your nationality is, the reason why I ask you to believe in the Bible. Some people will be saying, no, what's your nationality? You like Irish? Then what Christian is not a nationality, but it's according to the Bible, salvation.
Chapter 5, verse 29.
Yep.
Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than men.
Yep.
The God of our fathers raised up Jesus, whom he slew and hung on a tree. Him hath God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, but to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins.
So forgiveness of sins, forgiveness of sins. And the Gentiles are Israelites that were part of the Commonwealth of Israel at a particular time. They even look like they're Israelites. They don't teach you that in church. They tell you that in church that you made salvation. So you can possibly be Israelite. Only the God has to put down there in the right place.
I didn't believe that.
All right, man.
All right.
So where was he at? So the Lord's word doesn't go out void, man. It's always fulfilled, okay? His word is always going to be fulfilled. And he speaks his word through his prophets, man. Lord willing, where some of those men, starting off with the apostles, the elders, a great millstone. Okay, put that in on that.
There's the book of Isaiah, chapter 55, verse 11. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please.
So it's going to accomplish that which the Lord pleased, which is ultimately the destruction of America, the salvation of the elect of Israel, and the establishment of the kingdom of Israel here on the earth by way of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, okay? And bringing the holy angels back, man. It's going to happen, man. A lot of you jets, you don't believe that this is going to happen. Or it's going to happen, but not in my life. I got enough time to go do what I want to do. You know you don't. Time is running short. Time is of the essence. Now is the time to repent.
That's okay? Right.
And so the closing scripture I want to get was that it on that?
And it shall prosper in the things whereto I sent thee.
And it's going to prosper where it sent thee. So the closing scripture I got is get Romans 11, sorry, 13 and 11. Romans 13 and 11.
The book of Romans, chapter 13, verse 11. And that, knowing the time.
Yeah, like knowing the time. How do you know the time? By seeing the prophecies, man. By watching the news, whether they be alternative or mainstream news. By lining up what's happening in the world today with the prophecies that are written about in the scriptures beforehand. Because the things that are written beforehand were written for our learning.
that now is the high time to awake out of sleep.
Okay, our people, the people on this side here, these so-called Americans, and Native Americans, you in a state of sleep, a spiritual sleep, okay? Now it's time to wake up out of that sleep, okay?
For now, is our salvation nearer than when we believe?
Our salvation is nearer than when we believe, brothers. Now ain't the time to be getting scared. Now ain't the time to be getting weary. Now ain't the time to be giving up. Why? Because our salvation is nearer than when we believe.
That's right.
You don't gotta wait 500 years. You don't gotta wait 2-3 years. Man, it's almost there. Yahweh Shai is getting ready. He's at the threshold.
And when right.
And once he crossed that threshold, ain't no turning back. Once you get in this truth, ain't no turning back.
That's right.
Once you get in this truth and you put your hand in the plow, ain't no looking back. Because he that put his hand to the plow and looking back is not fit for the kingdom of heaven.
That's right.
Now is the time to grip down, bite down, do the work. Be instant in season, out of season. Do the work of the evangelist. Be a brother. Love your brother. That's the time we in, because the Lord is coming back in your lifetime. Keep reading.
That's right.
The night is far spent.
Yep, the night is far spent. Go ahead.
The day is at hand.
The day is at hand.
Let us therefore cast out the works of darkness.
Yeah, what are the works of darkness? Evil, wickedness, sin, homosexuality, lustiness, extortion, lying, effeminate, okay? Murdering, stealing, okay? Breaking the law, statute, of the commandments of Yahweh Shin Yahweh Shai. Cast those ways off. Read.
And let us put on the armor of light.
What is the armor of light? This truth, this word, this faith.
Let us walk honestly as in the day, not in rioting and drunkenness.
Yeah, we ain't supposed to be out, our women ain't supposed to be out here butt naked, all carrying on. Our men ain't supposed to be all effeminate, carrying on. Sodomites and whores. Cast that off, man. Okay? Go ahead.
Not in chambering and wantonness.
Not in chambering and wantonness, looking around, trying to figure something else out. Go ahead and read.
Not in strife and envy.
Yeah, not envying one another, strifing with one another. Brothers in this truth, man, we all got a portion of the spirit, man. Whether that be a great amount or a little amount. Everybody got their portion of the spirit enough to get them through, man. Yahweh Shin Yahweh Shai didn't call us in his truth to fall out, man. He called us in his truth to endure to the end. He gonna make sure we endure to the end, because he said it.
Right.
And his word don't go out void. Read.
But put ye on the Lord Yahweh Shai Mashiach.
Put ye on the Lord Yahweh Shin Yahweh Shai Mashiach. Not the world, not the ways of the world, man. The Lord has one name, Yahweh. His son has one name, Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
Go ahead.
And make not provision for the flesh.
Yeah, we're not doomsday prepping. We're not asking nobody else to help. We're depending on Yahweh Shin Yahweh Shai.
That's right. To fulfill the lust thereof.
To fulfill your lust thereof. Because that's all it is, man. When you're trying to save your own life. Hey, man, we ain't living. And this life that we in right now, this is not life. This is death.
That's
right. We're in the shadow of death. Okay? So any provisions you make, you're just trying to prolong your situation here. We in slavery. We seeking to be loosed. Okay? Go ahead.
Chapter 14.
Was that it right there? That was it?
Yeah, I was at this chapter.
All right, so amen. With that, man, we want to give all praises and honor and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Rakam, Kodash. Double honor to the apostles and elders at Great Millstone for teaching the word and truth and sincerity and for ruling well. Salutations to our fellow Africans across the four corners of the globe. Keep pushing, keep striving. We almost out of here.
Shalom.
By the book. Hey, you already see. Hey, that's right.
All right. And for all these Jews and Gentiles in Hebrew. Shalom, Mr. Ben Zolah.
You hear it? Hey. Hey, Barak, how about you? Y'all inside. Hey, with that, man, Lord willing, we see you brothers next week. Hey.